What's up, guys? Welcome to today's episode where we are doing a full day of eating. What I've got here is 6 ounces of 2% Greek yogurt, 100 grams of frozen blueberries, and we're gonna throw some cinnamon on top of that. Just a little dash there. We're gonna mix that up. And then we're going to take our MRE bar from Redcon One, and we are going to use this as kind of our utensil. This is the cookie dough flavor. Just take a bite first. It's pretty good. But what I like to do with my protein bars is dip them into my yogurt and sort of use it like a spoon. You can take a bite here and there, or just eat the yogurt off of it. Or just break the bar up into little pieces. Just throw it in to help flavor your yogurt. Now, guys, you can pick up these MRE bars at redcon1.com. Link is down in the description box. Use my code T20ChaseI to get 20% off. However, no more buying one bar at a time, all right? You can only buy boxes at a time now. Boxes or no more one bars at a time. All right, if you want one bar, make sure you're ordering it with a protein powder or something else. So, all right, no more one bar at a time. But you can order a pack of bars if you just want bars. You can order a box of them, box of 12, I believe they go for about 36 bucks from Redcon One. Link is down in the description box. The macros on these are 20 grams of protein, 29 grams of carbs and 9 grams of fat. With those kind of macros, it would be best to use this bar either pre-workout or post-workout because you want those carbs to help fuel your lifting. I used to do bars all the time. When I was in college, I used to do this exact thing. I would dip, what protein bar was I using then? I can't remember, but I mean, it was similar to this. I mean, I would just dip and take a small bite. This was my favorite meal of the day back then. I think I might be bringing it back. I mean, because this is a nice treat. Now, a lot of people don't like Greek yogurt, but I think there are different ways you can try it. This being one way. If you still don't like it like this, your next option is to put a scoop of protein powder right on top of the yogurt and mix that in to help flavor it a lot more, which I'll be doing soon. So anyways, guys, that was meal one. That was my pre-workout meal. Today we are doing back. And yeah, with back, doing the usual intro workout shake that we do. So I will see you guys in a couple hours. All right, guys, it is time to put together our intra-workout shake. So we're gonna put in 5 grams of B5. B5 is not really an intra-workout priority. I've stated in the past, B5 helps keep your sebaceous glands dried out in a way to prevent breakouts, acne, stuff like that. I just have it stored in a C4 container. Eventually these will be stored in Redcon 1 containers once I build up enough of them. Next, we're gonna put in 1,000 milligrams of potassium. Again, not C4, potassium. And then the same of sodium. Next, we're gonna put in 2 scoops of Breach by Redcon 1. Yeah, 1 scoop has 5 grams of BCAAs. We're gonna be doing 2. So 10 grams of BCAAs. Then we've got 10 grams of creatine. This will eventually be replaced by Tango by Redcon 1, but it's out of stock currently. It's supposed to get back in stock this week. The moment it does, I'm gonna buy it. Oops, I need that super. 10 grams of beetroot powder. This is a vasodilator, similar to citrulline malate, so it's like a pump product. Next, we're gonna do 5 grams of taurine. I'm doing 5 grams for my back workout. Usually it's about 3 grams is the dose for this, but I'm trying to prevent back pumps. That's what taurine does, is it helps prevent cramping. But I've heard take more taurine to prevent back pumps. And if you don't know what back pumps are, you haven't been lifting long enough. Then 10 grams of citrulline malate, which, as I said, is a vasodilator pump product. All right, so for liquid in this, we're gonna put in some pomegranate juice. Oh, man, I'm dropping shit everywhere. Fuck. All right, finally. 8 ounces of this. Reason I'm doing 8 ounces is because this is actually pomegranate juice and cherry juice in a 50-50 mix. So I put in 8 ounces, that gives me 4 ounces of pomegranate juice, 4 ounces of cherry juice. The 4 ounces of pomegranate juice is great for scrubbing plaque from your arteries, which prevents heart attacks, prevents stroke. Increases blood flow. Cherry juice, I have read, helps prevent muscle soreness somehow. A lot of people be drinking. My girlfriend drinks tart cherry juice. I don't know if cherry juice, tart cherry juice, whatever. Either way, the main thing is I want pomegranate juice. This was pomegranate cherry juice. So 8 ounces. And make sure you put the fucking lid back on. Straight. Then we're doing 6 ounces of pineapple juice. Pineapple juice is great for digestion. You guys are wondering, why am I using so much juice and dextrose? We're gonna add 50 grams of dextrose. Because it is back day. It is the one muscle group that I really have been trying to bring up. this whole series, this whole 114 days we've been going. All right, so we shake this up. And then we fill this with water. All right, so this is ready to go. I just need to take some T3 because it's time for that. And guys, if you're gonna ever buy T3, don't just go on Google and search T3 because you're gonna get some real fake fucked up shit. T3 is a prescription drug. Okay, if it doesn't look like this, this is Tyromel 25. It doesn't look like this, and if it doesn't come in like blister packets, you've probably got some bullshit. Like, it shouldn't be. Don't buy the research chems where it's mixed in liquid, because the dose of this stuff is so small, 25 micrograms, not milligrams. Milligrams are easy to dose out in liquid. Micrograms, like this stuff, is potent in small amounts. Like, if you accidentally take 100 micrograms, like, that's going to fuck you up. Your heart rate is gonna go through the roof. Especially if you take it in one dose. Like, I take 75 micrograms a day, spread out in 3 doses. Why do I take it? It improves your whole metabolism. It increases protein turnover rate, meaning your body goes through protein quicker, it absorbs protein quicker, it uses protein quicker. If you aren't eating enough protein, your body's going to be eating its muscle though. But it increases your heart rate, and through all that, it burns fat. You know, if your diet is in check, it will burn lots of fat, keep you lean. So that's that. That's the intro workout shake for back day. I'm gonna go do some back. I'm gonna leave you guys here. Be back to you guys with my post-workout meal. All right, guys, we just got home from the gym and had a solid back routine. Did some deadlifts for the first time in a while, and back feels great. So, stopped by the grocery store, picked up some steaks and some beef, and we're going to start up the grill and get shit cooking. Sun rises, I wake up and chase my dreams. I won't regret when the sun sets, cause I live my life like I'm a beast. Hey yo, back to make you run around again like it's a fire. I spit acid, bitch, like I got cyanide in my saliva. Watch me wet and heat shit up like I'm a washer and a dryer. While I beat you in your head until you tired. I'm a motherfucking beast. Guys, I wanted to make a little announcement here. Today, I found out that a Chicago bodybuilder, Jake of Bomb Squad Fitness, passed away today of a heart attack at the age of 37. He was a bodybuilder. He had his company, Bomb Squad Fitness, where he, I mean, I saw him, I saw his hashtag all over the place. He was a coach for men and women. It seemed like he had a ton of girls under his training, but yeah, he passed away of a heart attack at the age of 37. And I mean, he was a big guy. He was a big muscular guy, so you can, you know, I mean, rest in peace. But it's just something that. It needs to be addressed that this industry is not the healthiest. I mean, I don't know all the details, but
You know, it's just a heart attack plus a bodybuilder. I mean, it's just, usually it's something that can be avoided. Like I said, you know, we don't know all the specifics of everything, but yeah, and still, it's just, it's sad. And it's just, I don't want to make any assumptions about him and what he was doing. But I mean, guys, let's use our common sense here. Bodybuilding, heart attack, age 37. That doesn't happen unless, you know, something's not right. And that's why I take, like, that, those fucking tackle boxes of pills you see. That's why I take those, to prevent anything from that happening. That's why we get blood work. That's why we get a calcium scan of our heart. That's why we check all these things, which I'll be doing in July to make sure that I'm good to go. And, yeah, I mean, it's just, it's too bad. A lot of people are posting on Instagram right now, beat up about it. Anyways, guys, life's too short. All right, I gotta flip these steaks.
All right, guys, I'm gonna make up 1 cup of instant rice. Alright guys, time for my last meal. I'm just gonna get an 8-ounce burger patty. 1 8-ounce burger patty. This is gonna be my low carb meal. I'm gonna get just a handful of carrots, fistful of carrots, and then we're gonna add to it a fistful of almonds. Fistful of almonds. Last but not least, chipotle aioli. I love this stuff. It's a nice fat source. And as always, seasoned salt. Quick and basic, easy to eat, easy to prep. Meal. Guys, there's no reason to overcomplicate shit. No reason to overcomplicate things. This is a tasty burger. Alright, guys. I'm just gonna finish that, and that's gonna be my afternoon. Thank you. Thank you so much for your support so far. It's been great. We're doing awesome. Redcon One sales are doing great. If you guys need any protein, anything at all, please, please. The best way to support the channel right now is to use Redcon One for all your supplements. You know, we're on our way to 150 sales. We're doing great, but we gotta keep going. So if you need any protein, any BCAAs, pre-workout, cases of bars, yeah, if you guys need anything at all, please, please use my code T20CHASEI and, you know, let's get up the ranks in Redcon 1. One thing I've been thinking a lot lately that, you know, I keep reminding myself, and it's a great motto to live by in the world of sport and fitness. Nobody cares, train harder. And that goes for everything. Nobody cares. Nobody cares about your fucking excuses. Nobody cares if you don't have time. Train harder, diet harder, lift harder, work harder, grind harder. Fucking just, you know, we're only here once. Get your shit done. Nobody cares about your excuses. Train harder. All right, guys, thanks for stopping by, and I will see you tomorrow. The fucking base!